Very good morning to everyone. In this lecture WE8451, Linear Integrated Circuits and Applications. Today we are going to discuss about the unit 3, Applications of Operational Amplifier, in the topic of Analog Multiplier and Divider. Here first we considered the Analog Multiplier ICs. The Analog Multiplier is a circuit whose output voltage at any instant is proportional to the product of instantaneous value of two individual input voltage. The important application of these amplifier are multiplication, division, squaring and square rooting of signals, modulation and demodulations are occur. These anti-log, that is analog multiplier, are available on integrated circuits consisting of operational amplifier and the circuit elements. So here the two port network model, here the Vx and Vy is a two input voltages. So that we converted to the analog multiplier is a single output V naught. So the multiplier ICs and the symbols are there. So there is a 8 pins multiplier. So there is a X1 to X1, X2, Y1, Y2, and also the supply voltages and W, Z and V out. So here the multiplications operations of the X1 and X2 using the single stage amplifier, and then Y1 and Y2 amplifier is mixed, that is multiplied to the output is given to the summing amplifier. So the summing amplifier circuit was a non-inverting, and inverting is fed to the output of the 7th pin configurations. So here the complete model of the analog multiplier IC design. Now we are moving to this AD633 multiplier is a 4 quadrant analog multiplier. It possesses high input impedance. These characteristics make the loading effect on the single source negligible. It can operate with supply voltages ranging from plus or minus 18 volt, and then the IC does not require external components, and the typical range of the two input signal is a plus or minus 10 volt. Now the schematic representation. The schematic representation is of an analog multiplier. The output, that is V naught, is product of the two input Vx and Vv, is divided by a reference voltage V reference. Normally the reference voltage V reference is internally set to 10 volt. Therefore the output voltage is equal to Vx Vy divided by 10. In other words, the basic input and output relationship can be defined by the Vx Vy. Why, when the k equal to 1 divided by 10 is a constant value of the multiplier, thus the peak input voltage of 10 volt, the peak magnitude output voltage is 1 divided by 10 into the 10 into 10 equal to 10 volt. Thus it can be noted that as long Vx less than 10 volt and Vy less than 10 volt, for multipliers output will not saturated. Now we can see the applications of multivibrator circuits. The circuit are used in the following purpose: number 1, voltage squarer; number 2, frequency doubler; number 3, voltage divider; number 4, square rooter; number 5, phase angle detector; number 6, rectifier. So there are so many applications are needed to analog multiplier integrated circuit using the operational amplifier. Now we move on to the voltage squarer applications. The multiplier IC, that is a IC connected as a squaring circuit, the input can be positively or negative, represented by any corresponding voltage level between the 0 and 10 volt. The input voltage to be squared is a simple connected to both the input terminals, and here we have Vx equal to Vy equal to Vi, and the output is V naught equal to KVi2. The circuit thus performs the squaring operations This application can be extended for frequency doubling applications. So now we can see the voltage squaring circuit in the single input and single output operational amplifier, the Vin and Vout equal to K into Vi square. Now we can move to the frequency doubler. The squaring circuit connected for frequency doubling operation, a sine wave signal, that is an input voltage, has a peak amplitude of the voltage gain and the frequency of f hertz. Then the output voltage of the doubler circuit is given by V out equal to voltage gain into sine 2 pi f t plus voltage gain into sine 2 pi f t divided by 10 equal to voltage gain square divided by 10 sine square 2 pi f t into the voltage gain square divided by 20 into 1 minus cos 4 pi f c t. So yeah, this is the input and output configurations, that is a voltage doubler circuit. Here the input voltage applied to the both the input of x1 and y1, so the output of the single input, single output to throw the initial supply voltage of 15 volt. Now we can see the voltage divider. In the voltage divider circuits, the division is achieved by connecting the multiplier in the feedback loop of an operational amplifier. The voltage V and voltage number represent the two input voltages, that is a VDM from one input of the multiplier, and the output of operational amplifier VOA forms the second input. The output VOA forms the second input. The output VOM of the multiplier is connected back of an operational amplifier is the feedback loop. Then the characteristics of operation of the multiplier gives the VOM equal to K into VOA into VDM. So see, the divider circuit, it can be the output is feedback to the Y1, so the input is applied to the input voltage of the amplifier, so it can be neglected the input voltage and the output current, so it can be the output is a voltage divided to 1 into K VOA into VDM. Now it assume a peak amplitude of the voltage gain of 5 volt and the frequency f of 10 kilohertz. So the first term represent the DC term of 1.25 volt peak amplitude value. Then the input and output waveforms are shown. The output waveforms ripple with twice the input frequency in the rectified output of the input signal. From this forms the principle of operation of analog multiplier divider as a rectifier of a AC signal. Here we can see the no input signal, that is a current cannot flow into the inverting input terminal of an operational amplifier which is at virtual ground. Therefore, at a junction of I1 plus I2 equal to 0, the current I1 equal to V into divided by R, where R is the input resistance and the current I2 with the virtual ground existing at the I1 plus I2 is equal to V divided by R plus V0 divided by R equal to 0. Here the output voltage gain equal to V divided by KV in, where the numerator and the denominator voltages respectively. Therefore, the voltage divider operation is achieved. The numerator voltage can be positive or negative voltage, and the denominator voltage can have only positive voltage values to ensure the negative feedback. When VDM is changes, the gain 10 voltage changes, and this features is used to automatic gain control AGC circuits. Now we can see the square router. The divider voltage is the division voltage can be used to find the square root of a signal by connecting both inputs and of the multiplier to the output of the operational amplifier. So substituting the equation in magnitude but opposite in polarity with respect to the ground Vi, but we know the output voltage is one term, that is a scale factor of V naught into convolution of V naught or minus Vi equal to Vom equal to V square divided by 10. So solving for V naught and eliminating the V minus 1 yield the V naught is equal to root of 10 divided by Vi. From these equations state that V naught equal to the square root of the 10 times the absolute magnitude of Vi, the input voltage Vi must be negative or else the operational amplifier saturates. The range of the Vi is between the minus 1 and minus 10 volt. The voltage less than the minus 1 volt will cause the inaccurrence in the result. The diode prevent the negative saturation for positive polarity Vi signal for positive values of the Vi. The diode connections are reversed. So in this lecture we are discussed the analog multiplier and divider circuits using the operational amplifier. Thank you for watching this video.